Holy crap. All the dust, I haven't used it for many. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Mr. Electron. The transformer that you see is a 250 watts transformer. The two terminals, yellow and blue, these two are secondary low voltage, high current winding output terminals on which a 24 volts 10 amperes appear. And these two red and yellow wires, these are the 220 volts input side of this transformer. The bolts that this transformer initially had got lost, so I used the pretty longer ones. Although I could cut them with an angle grinder from here, but still it is not creating any problem, so I'm going to stick with these. Okay, so let's do the continuity check on this transformer with the help of a multimeter. So the multimeter is pointed towards the continuity checking mode. Okay, so first the low voltage, secondary winding, high current side. Yeah, it's working. Now comes the high voltage side. Yeah, so high voltage side, you can see the resistance is somewhere around 9 ohms. And here you can see that the resistance is only 2 ohms. Okay, so this makes sure that this is the high current side and this is the high voltage low current side. So guys, with that being done, let's connect 220 volts AC supply to check its output. Okay, connecting it to the supply. At present, the supply is turned off just for safety purposes. Now I will turn it on and connect a multimeter on these two terminals and it should give me some voltage at the meter screen. So let's also connect the meter. The output is obviously going to be AC, so pointing towards 200 volts AC mode. So guys, now I'm going to turn on the supply and you should see some voltage reflected on the display screen. Keep watching. So guys, here as you can see that the output voltage is somewhere around 27.2 volts. They have increased the voltage from 24 to 27 because when they connect an actual good amount of 10 amperes load, then the voltage will automatically get dropped to 24 volts. So this way they can maintain the voltage and current by increasing the voltage, open circuit voltage. Okay. So guys, this bulb that you see here is 250 watts. You can see here 24 volts, and the side of it is written 250 watts. So I'm going to use this bulb to check its output current. So 250 watts means that it is going to draw 10 amps from this transformer. Okay, one terminal like this, another one like this. Yeah, it is getting really hot. Once again, oh yeah, it's very hot. So the transformer and supply and the bulb, all of them are working perfectly fine. Now it's time to go to the next step. So guys, for this kind of setup, we are first going to need a bridge rectifier. I'm going to use a 35 amp rectifier, which is the most common available in the electronics market. It's a single phase rectifier, Vanco. So AC terminal is this one, the black one, thick one. So diagonal opposite is also the other AC terminal. Remaining two are the DC terminal, since this black one is positive and then blue one is going to be negative. So let's connect it to the AC supply from the output of the transformer. Okay, so this has been connected. Another DC terminals. Let's interchange the black and blue terminal because usually the black is used for negative. So now blue is the positive and black is the negative. So guys, since we are not using this terminal, so let's cover it with tape. It might contain some AC ripples. Okay. So guys, now comes the part where I'm going to add the filter circuit to this transformer. Although I'm not going to actually add the filter circuit, all I'm going to do is purify the DC coming out from the rectifier with the help of this simple capacitor. You can see it's rating 31,000 microfarad at 50 volts DC, and this is producing somewhere around 27.7 volts. So this capacitor suits pretty good for the job. Okay, so this has polarity, as you can see, plus, and this one is minus, so it has to be connected to the circuit accordingly. Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit that bell icon for similar video notifications. Also, do comment on what else you would like me to add to this present video. Best regards, Electron. So guys, here you can see I've added the capacitor and the setup is fully complete. Now when I will measure the voltage with this multimeter, it is going to be a little more than the measured voltage without the capacitor and rectifier. Even though there is forward biasing voltage drop across the rectifier, still the overall output voltage is going to be more. I think it is going to be more than 30 in DC. So let's point it towards 200 volts DC mode. Okay, and touch the meter. You can see the voltage increased from 27.7 volts to 38.8 volts. Because initially when the meter was connected in AC, it was measuring the average value. But now when it is connected to the capacitor, it is measuring the peak value, the highest voltage point to which the capacitor can get charged. So the capacitor gets charged to that value and this meter reflects the charge on the capacitor. So guys, one final check. So the voltage is close to 39 volts. So guys, this what you see is an electric screwdriver that I made from a 220 volts old drill machine that was not working initially. So it runs on 30 volts power supply. So I'm going to run it with this power supply. Just for testing. The video for modification of this drill machine to DC drill is still in my video list. You can check it out. So you can see the wire connecting it like this and pressing this button. You can see it is working perfectly. Now comes the other way. Okay. Working really nice. So the DC supply is working pretty good. And guys, in one of my previous videos, you saw me modify this high speed air blower, and I used this DC motor. As you can see, it's a 12 volts high current DC motor. You can see the winding is so thick. The current intake is somewhere around 32 amperes. So many of you said the voltage is not enough, or the speed is very low. So I'm going to test this blower with this power supply. Yeah, this one is strong. So both the terminals have been connected. Now it's time to test it. Okay, so guys, the supply has been connected. Let's turn it on. Yeah, I think now it's high speed enough for you people, right? Although because of the Murphy's law, it always operates in the opposite direction if we connect the wires without considering the polarity. So let's connect it in the opposite. Okay, so initially you didn't hear the sound of a wind, but now you will. Yeah. Okay. So assuming that this is some garbage, which it actually is, at least now it is. So let's push it away. Yeah, so you can see it is working at a really good speed. So guys, now let's connect this 12 volts 32 amperes DC motor, a similar one of which I used in the air blower that you just saw. Okay, so it is going to make a lot of spark. The current is going to be very high. Oh, actually I turned off the supply and it sparked just for a second because the capacitor was charged. So beware with that, guys. Capacitor is charged and the voltage is very high. It's very dangerous. Okay, once again. Holy crap. All the dust. I haven't used it for many months, so because of which there was dust all over inside the armature. Once again. Oh. the wire got stuck. Yeah, it's working at a pretty good speed. The power supply is very good. And one more thing, guys, this capacitor that I've added to the end of the rectifier, it adds up to the short circuit current. So the meaning of this is that if this transformer is capable of producing or converting around 10 amperes, then this capacitor will add up to that 10 amperes, and increasing its amps just for a millisecond or 1 second, like doubling up the amps to 20 amps or 30 amps. So guys, this is the long halogen, 220 volts and 1000 watts. Okay, you can see that is very long, just like a stick, and the filament is also very thick. And because the filament is thick, I can glow this halogen even at just 40 volts. Although the illumination is not going to be so great, but still it is going to work. Okay, so let's connect it. So guys, you can see that it is glowing. So guys, you can see without the lights, it is glowing pretty good. Looks really nice. Okay, so guys, this is a 180 volt, 7.5 amps, 1.5 hp, 4000 rpm PMDC motor, large PMDC motor that I'm going to use to test this circuit. Okay, so these are the two terminals, red and black. So let's connect them to the capacitor output terminals. Okay, so the first one is connected. Now comes the second one. Obviously the motor is big, and because of the inertia disk, it is going to create a short circuit for some time, because the moment of inertia is zero at present. Okay, you can see, you can see that it is running pretty good. A 1.5 hp DC motor that is running flawlessly, and it is almost unstoppable. Yeah, it is unstoppable with hands, of course. It is very strong at 40 volts, and its full power will be seen at 180 volts. At present, it is only 40 volts. So guys, that would be all about today's video on how to make a 24 to 40 volts DC power supply from a 220 volts transformer by AC to DC conversion at 10 amperes. So thank you so much for watching it. Please hit like and don't forget to share and subscribe. And if you have any queries, you can always ask them in comments. Thank you.